Hello everyone, this is Revan from Digi Integrative. Welcome to Tech News episode 274. Income Tax Department raided several locations related to cases related to two businesses, one involved in cheat fund and financing, while the other is a retailer of silk sarees and other garments. The taxmen conducted searches across 34 premises located in Kanchipuram, Chennai and Vellore. The tax department has uncovered unaccounted income into the tune of 250 crore rupees for these searches, according to the Central Board of Direct Taxes. A new WhatsApp scam has come up, which is named as Rediroff.com. The scam has been circulated on the WhatsApp-owned instant messaging application for a few days now. According to the reports, fraudsters are using WhatsApp scam to rob users of their personal and financial data like bank and card details. The spam link can also affect Windows PCs along with iOS and Android smartphones. In March 2021, Asus unveiled the ROG Phone 5 series comprising of the ROG Phone 5, 5 Pro and 5 Ultimate. Later in August, the company launched the updated version of the phones dubbed as ROG Phone 5S and 5S Pro. Now Asus seems to be gearing up to launch this year's gaming phone as new 2D renders of the upcoming Asus ROG Phone 6 and 6 Pro have arrived on the internet. According to the reports, we may not confirm that Asus 8Z will be launching or not. Meanwhile, the upcoming Zenfone 9 and ROG Phone 6 has been spotted on the Asus ZenTalk discussion. OnePlus 10 Pro launch date in China is on January 11th and promo video has been leaked online. The video also confirmed that the upcoming flagship design, OnePlus will likely officially begin teasing the launch of the OnePlus 10 Pro soon. Vivo sub-brand IQ has shared a 4-picture with the shot of IQ 9 Pro's 150-degree ultra-wide-angle camera, two of which were captured in fisheye mode. You can check out the screen. IQ previously confirmed that IQ 9 series will feature a 50-megapixel Samsung GNS camera with the gimbal stabilization, which will be joined by a 150-degree ultra-wide-angle camera unit on an IQ 9 Pro. The company also confirmed that IQ 9 series will come with a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor, 2K 120Hz C5 AMOLED display, in-screen fingerprint scanner and a 4700mAh battery with 120W wired 50W wireless charging support. OnePlus 9, OnePlus 9R and OnePlus 8T phones could be discontinued in India after OnePlus 9RT launches. The company appears to be gearing up to launch the OnePlus 9RT in India. OnePlus 9RT originally launched in China back in October. Moto is expected to launch the Moto G71 in India soon. It had launched a total of 5 smartphones in the global market. Moto G71 was launched at €299 in Europe, that is around ₹25,200. Oppo Enco M32 wireless earphones priced in India will be ₹1,499. The Bluetooth earphones will be launching in the country on January 5th. Oppo Enco M32 will come with a 10mm dynamic drivers, Bluetooth 5.0, low latency IP55 rating for dust and water resistance, and 28 hours battery life. The Exynos 2200 is coming sooner than expected. The new flagship chipset with the AMD graphics will be debuting on January 11. This is a week after CES and the rumored date for the Galaxy S21 Fan Edition launch. Of course, a Fan Edition will be using the older Snapdragon triplet processor and the Exynos 2100 chipset. The new chipset will be reserved for the upcoming Galaxy S22 series, which are expected to arrive in February. A total of 4 smartphones were supposed to join the Realme UI 3.0 Early Access program in December 2021. Users of 3 of these devices can already taste Android 12. At last, one of the final day of the year, Realme kickstarted the initiative for the 4th and the last devices in the list, Realme GT Master Edition. Realme has opened registrations for the Realme GT Master Edition Realme UI 3.0 Early Access program, and the company made an official announcement on Realme community. Xiaomi's independent Redmi brand is expected to launch the Redmi K50 series soon, with the series tipped to come with a gaming edition. The Redmi K50 gaming edition has now been certified by China's 3C, giving us an idea of the charging speed. The 3C certification shows the device will come with a staggering 120W fast charging support. Vivo is planning to enter the tablet market with the Vivo Pad. According to the report, the device will be launching in the early 2022. As per the report, the Vivo Pad will feature a display with the high refresh rate. Although the report does not reveal the size, it says that the display will offer a full screen experience as it will sport a thin bezel. The Xiaomi 12 series, comprised of the Xiaomi 12, 12 Pro and 12X, went on sale for the first time today in China, end up selling over 1.8 billion Chinese yuan, that is around $283 million, which is worth of units in just 5 minutes through both offline and online channels. Xiaomi Group partner and senior vice president has announced a review of the brand's air conditioner business for the year 2021. The vice president disclosed that Xiaomi sold over 2 million units of its air conditioner during the period under review spanning from January 1, 2021 to December 31, 2021. Xiaomi's air conditioner have turned out to be one of the brand's popular product, and the sales report has says the fact. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.